As we heard, it's certainly going to be another scorcher for Melbourne and Adelaide today, with that heatwave rolling on and sending temperatures soaring across parts of South Australia and Victoria. For more on the heat, let's bring in meteorologist Sarah Scully from the Weather Bureau. Sarah, so many Australians will be waking up this morning thinking, I didn't get much sleep last night because it was hot overnight, wasn't it?
You're exactly right. It was actually the hottest day morning in over 100 years for the people who woke up in Hobart. But as well for Melburnians, the temperature hovered around 30 degrees for the majority of the night before getting down to around 27.2 degrees earlier this morning. And as you mentioned, it is going to be another really hot day today. We're forecasting maximum temperatures to be between 10 to 15 degrees above average again, and to be sort of between mid 30s to high 30s and even reaching to the low 40s as we move inland.
Yeah, so no respite for people living in those states, but also for firefighters. How does that alter fire conditions?
Yeah, that's right. High temperatures, of course, always add to fire danger. And in particular, a focus area today is about the Eyre Peninsula for South Australia and also the west coast of South Australia, where we're seeing extreme fire dangers.
When is some of the cooler weather expected? When can we see some relief?
Look, we've got a southerly change that's expected to push up into southern parts of Victoria in the early hours of Tuesday morning. So we've still got another 2 days of really high temperatures. But that southerly change isn't expected to push past the Great Dividing Range. So it's going to remain hot northern parts of Victoria and also for parts of South Australia as well.
Is it unusual in these parts for it to be so hot, early into March?
Yeah, look, autumn is the transition season, so we're transitioning from the really hot temperatures of summer into winter. However, to have 3 days sort of, above 38 degrees for Melbourne, I think that's happened three times previously in the last 100 years. So it's unusual, but it's not unprecedented.
A warning for those living in parts of Western Australia too, Sarah, because they're being told to brace for severe thunderstorms.
That's right. Very different weather out in the west. We've got tropical moisture that's extending down from the Timor Sea, making a very large rain band. And there's the potential for severe thunderstorms to form anywhere within that rain band. But on top of that, we have a severe weather warning current for heavy rainfall, locally intense rainfall that may lead to life-threatening flash flooding. And that's for the southeast parts of WA. So from the southern interior extending down into the Eucla area. And it's a really slow-moving rain band or weather system, and so we're forecasting that heavy rainfall to continue for Monday and into Tuesday at least. So if you do live within that area, stay up to date with our latest warnings.
Well, it really is a land of extremes, isn't it? Sarah Scully from the Weather Bureau, thank you so much. Jane.
Thank you.
Well, millions across the country's southeast are right now waking up after sweating through extremely hot conditions overnight. Temperatures in both Melbourne and Adelaide barely dropped below 30 degrees before 4 a.m. Conditions aren't forecast to improve much today, with both capitals set to hit 39 by this afternoon. And it's not looking much better tomorrow, reaching 38 degrees. Melbourne will see some relief on Tuesday, while Adelaide will hit a very warm 34. And organisers of Melbourne's iconic Moomba Festival were forced to cancel tomorrow's annual parade. But a music and arts festival in the state's west is forging ahead despite those heat and fire warnings.